Kyiv military 55 times shelled inhabited localities of Donbas during 24 hours. Cities Donetsk, Makiivka, Gorlovka were the main targets of artillery and rocket launchers of Washington-backed forces. Witnesses report Kyiv troops using incendiary and cluster shells. Kyiv forces which were shelling Donetsk are deployed in Toninka and Avdiivka. The north part of the city is target of their shelling. Two locals were killed and nine locals were injured there. The main clashes are continuing in the Baltsevas pocket. Military of People's Republic take control of more than 10 kilometers of highway A40. It's the only way which Kyiv can use for supplying their group in the Baltseva. Today, forces of Donetsk and Lugansk People's Republic stopped fire and assisted in evacuation of group of civilians from the town. Around settlement Chernuhina, forces of People's Republic surrounded Company 25 of Washington-backed battalion Kyivskaya Rus. They tried flee from the pocket by trucks and tanks, but they lost few dozen of fighters and stepped back. The settlement is still controlled by so-called National Guard of Ukraine. NGU fighters are frightened by storm. They mined almost all Chernuhina and roads around it. Washington-backed Kyiv forces shelled the town Gorlovka from their positions in Artomovsk and Mayorsk. Forces of Donetsk People's Republic were going offensive in this sector today. The clashes are going there now. Same time, the NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg said that situation in Ukraine critical, but NATO supports peace efforts. But the same time, North Atlantic Alliance is deploying new spearhead force in Eastern Europe, which will enable the alliance to respond to so-called security challenges posed by Russia. NATO defense ministers will also meet in the NATO-Georgia Commission format, together with the Georgian defense minister Mindia Janeldidze. They will discuss the implementation of the substantial NATO-Georgia package endorsed at the Wales summit. Apparently, NATO supports peace efforts by deploying their forces closer and closer to Russia. Also, anyone can watch the rising of political activity of the voices of US John Kerry and Victoria Nuland in Eastern Europe. We apparently cannot suppose that these facts are past related. In accordance with rising of NATO's military activity in Europe, aggressive US policy against Russia and its involvement into Ukrainian crisis, it's impossible to deny that tensity is rising in the Europe. The Ukrainian civil war have all chances become a regional conflict. And US, NATO official whom supply an economy, military and political aid for Kyiv are doing all what they can for it. We thank our information partners for help with spreading this video news.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel to receive up-to-date news on situation in Ukraine.